Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. So in this video, we will talk about web development and how you can do backend development like a pro using one of the best framework that is Java Spring Boot. Many of you have requested to bring something on Java Spring Boot. So here I am today to give you a complete review of a Spring Boot course for backend development. So if this sounds interesting, then stick around. Also, don't forget to subscribe the channel and press the bell icon so that you don't miss the videos like this one. So let's get started. All right, guys. So before we jump to Spring Boot directly, let's talk about what is web development. So web development is a process of creating and maintaining websites and web applications that are accessible over the internet using some technologies. And in web development, we have either the front-end development or the back-end development. The front-end development refers to creating and maintaining the user interface and user experience of a website or a web application. Technologies and languages that are used for front-end development are HTML, which is a markup language, CSS, JavaScript frameworks like React, Angular, Vue, and we use the build tools to build our application, that is the NPM, Webpack, or YARN. On the other side, the backend development is the process of creating and maintaining the server side of a web application or website. So unlike frontend, backend development deals with the logic, database operations, and server side process that enables the frontend to function properly. The technologies and languages usually used for the backend development is Java, we have a Spring Boot framework, Node.js, Express framework, Python, Django framework, and SQL or NoSQL databases. Now let's talk about what is Spring. So Spring is referred to as a Spring framework in Java application development, and it's widely used to create scalable enterprise level applications by providing a modular and a flexible approach to build web apps. Now here, one of the major challenges for the Spring projects is that its configuration is time consuming, which is challenging for the new developers. So here comes the Spring Boot framework. So why is Spring Boot one of the preferred backend framework? Spring Boot is built on top of the Spring framework that simplifies and accelerates the development of Java application, particularly web development and microservices. And some of the advantages of using Spring Boot in the project is that it provides auto configuration, industry demand, Spring ecosystem, simplified dependency injection, standalone applications, scalability and performance, and it's easy to test Spring Boot applications. The next question is, who should learn Spring Boot? So Spring Boot is an excellent choice for beginners, whether you are a final year student or a fresher with 0 to 2 years of experience. Let's discuss about what are the current trends of Spring Boot. So according to the Java Developer Productivity Report, 62% of the surveyed developers are using Spring Boot as the leading framework technology. Spring Boot is used by leading tech companies like Netflix, LinkedIn, Uber, Intuit as their backend framework. Now, these are the companies which are actively hiring for the Spring Boot developers. All right, so we have talked about the web development, backend development, Spring Boot. In this video, we will review a recent Spring Boot course launched by Coding Ninjas. So what you will learn in this course is divided into different modules. So you will learn about the basics of Spring Boot. Then for the next week, you're going to learn about the Beans, Scope, Lifecycle, Spring Annotations, MVC Core, RESTful API. Then you're going to build the projects, Hibernate and CRUD operations, Spring Data and JPA, Spring Security, Security Management, Logging, Microservices, and JUnit Testing. Let me give you the walkthrough of this course, what is included. So if I go to this dependency injection in Spring Boot, and here you will see that we have all the lectures. So you will see you have the overview of dependency injection, and you will see here all the videos. And apart from that, they also have the MCQs. So if we go to this, what is dependency injection? So as you go through the video, you will also need to assess yourself based on the MCQs. And these MCQs is really going to help you while you prepare for the interviews as well. And towards the end of each of the module, you're going to have a problem statement. So here you will see that we have the vaccine problem, and this is going to give us a problem statement. So you're going to go through the problem statement, you will try to build the solutions. And in case if we get stuck somewhere, then you also have the hint videos. So if you click on this link to the project, it is going to give you a zip where you will have the step-by-step guides and hints so that you can solve this problem. Now, other good part about the course is that if we have some doubts, so if we are going through this lecture and if we have a doubt, so you can just click on the Ask View Doubt, then a dialog box will appear where you will have four options: help with code, questions concept related, platform related, others. Let's click on this questions and concept related, and you will see that we have a lot of options here. So here you will have the concept video, hint video, question unclear. Let's say we have a doubt on the concept video. And then here I'm going to type that, what is the difference between auto-wired and constructor injection? So where we click on the submit, then you will see that we have submitted our doubt successfully and we have a chat window here. And here you will see that we connected to the instructors. So let's add the doubt again. And then we will see that the instructor is typing and then we have the answer. So this is how you're going to clear your doubts as soon as you go through all the videos. So I really like the doubt solving experience. So whenever we go through the videos and we get an instant doubt, so this can be solved is Now, the other aspect which I want to talk about this course is the quality of projects. So you're going to have a lot of projects which are more relevant to the industry. And these projects like the e-voting application, online banking, e-commerce application, expense manager. And as you progress in learning of the Spring Boot topics, you're going to build the project on the same. So overall, these projects are very much industry relevant and can help you to get better jobs and to crack your interviews. Now, let me show you how you can enroll to this course. So you can just click on the enroll now, then you can choose your plan. So let's choose the basic plan and I'm going to pick a batch and you will see that you instantly get a 50% early bird discount. But you can also get an additional 15% discount. For that, you just need to register for the discount. So you can go to this link. I will add the links in the description of the video so that you can check it out later on. You fill in the information and you register for the discount. As soon as you do it, you're going to get an additional 15% discount and then you can just make the payment and you can enroll to the course and you can continue your Spring Boot learning journey. Now let's talk about the course rating. So I have divided the course into four parameters and the first one is the course structure. So I'm rating it as a 7.5 out of 10. Next is the quality of faculty the course offers, which is 7 out of 10. Then we have the doubt solving experience, which is 7 out of 10. And in the end, we have the quality of projects, which is 6.5 out of 10. So overall, my recommendation for this course will be that if you are willing to learn the Spring Boot, then this course is a perfect fit for you. And I'm going to rate it as 7 out of 10 for this course, because this course has a lot of comprehensive concepts, then projects, and these projects are very industry relevant. You will find all the links in the description of the video so that you can check it out later on. So that's all I have in this video. So if you like the video, a thumbs up is appreciated. You can also connect with me via Facebook or Instagram. You can follow me on Twitter for latest updates. And before you go, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so that you don't miss the videos like this one. Thank you. Thanks for watching.